Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I am going to talk about the anatomy of the esophagus. What should you know about the esophagus? First, the length. It is about 25 centimeters long, so it is about 10 inches long. Then we'll talk about the extent of the esophagus, the beginning and the termination. It begins at the lower border of the cricoid cartilage as the continuation of the pharynx, and it ends at the cardiac orifice of the stomach. So we'll talk about it later. Okay, then we'll talk about the parts of the esophagus. The esophagus is divided into three parts. The first part is present in the neck, cervical part. Second part in the thorax, thoracic part. And the third part is the abdominal part. Actually, it can be divided into upper third in the neck, middle third in the thorax, and the lower third in the abdomen. However, the thoracic part is the longest part. Then we'll talk about the landmarks or the relations, the important relations of the esophagus. Then we'll talk about the constrictions of the esophagus. The esophagus has four constrictions. Then we'll talk about the blood supply, arterial and venous drainage, nerve supply, and lymph drainage. Start by the extent of the esophagus. Where does it begin and where does it end? It begins here, okay, at the lower border of the cricoid cartilage, opposite the sixth cervical vertebra, of course, as the continuation of the pharynx. So the first vertebral level you should remember is C6. The beginning. The termination, it terminates here at the cardiac orifice of the stomach. Okay, 1 inch of course to the left of the midline, opposite T11, opposite the 11th thoracic vertebra. You should remember three vertebral levels. C6 is the beginning, T11 is the termination, and the T10 is the esophageal hiatus in the diaphragm. So this is the beginning, lower border of the cricoid cartilage, C6. This is the termination, cardiac orifice of the stomach, T11. Actually, between T10 and the T11, this is the abdominal part of the esophagus. Then the divisions of the esophagus. The esophagus is divided into three parts. This is the first part, or cervical part in the neck. This is the second part, thoracic part in the thorax. In the thorax, it is present in the superior mediastinum and in the posterior mediastinum. And the third part here is present in the abdomen, abdominal part. So we have three parts, cervical in the neck, thoracic in the thorax, superior mediastinum and the posterior mediastinum, and the abdominal part in the abdomen. Then we'll talk about the landmarks or the important relations in the neck. In the neck, it lies behind the trachea and the recurrent laryngeal nerves. These are the recurrent laryngeal nerves separate the esophagus from the trachea. So this is important landmark in the neck, behind the trachea and the recurrent laryngeal nerves. These are the recurrent laryngeal nerves. In the thorax, it lies in the superior mediastinum and in the posterior mediastinum. In the superior mediastinum, it lies behind the trachea. Okay. In the posterior mediastinum, It lies behind the left atrium. This is the left atrium, behind the left atrium and the oblique sinus. It lies in front of three vessels: descending thoracic aorta, thoracic duct, and azygous vein. It is crossed by the left bronchus, where it is compressed. It is crossed by the left bronchus. This is the left bronchus and the aortic arch. It enters the abdomen through the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm. This is the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm opposite T10. In the abdomen, it lies behind the left lobe of the liver. So what are the important landmarks you should know? In the neck, behind the trachea and the recurrent laryngeal nerves. In the thorax, it lies in the superior mediastinum and the posterior mediastinum. In the superior mediastinum, it lies behind the trachea. It is crossed by the left bronchus, where it is compressed. The esophagus lies behind the left atrium and the oblique sinus. It lies in front of the descending aorta, thoracic duct, and azygous vein. And actually, it is surrounded by the esophageal plexus of nerves. These are the vagus nerves. In the abdomen, it lies behind the left lobe of the liver. Regarding the constrictions, the esophagus has four constrictions. The first constriction is at its beginning. So at the beginning, it is 15 centimeters from the incisors, from the incisor teeth. Okay, so the first constriction at the beginning, between the esophagus and the pharynx, 15 centimeters from the incisors. Second constriction, where it is crossed by the aortic arch. It is 23 centimeters from the incisors. The third constriction, at the left main bronchus, where it is crossed by the left main bronchus. It is 25 centimeters from the incisors. And the last constriction, okay, this is the last constriction in the esophageal hiatus, okay? It is 40 centimeters from the incisor teeth. So the four constrictions, the first one at the beginning, the second one at the aortic arch, the third one at the left main bronchus, and the fourth one at the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm. At the beginning, 15 centimeters from the incisor, opposite the aortic arch, 23 centimeters, and when crossed, where crossed by the left bronchus, 25 centimeters, and in the esophageal hiatus, it is 40 centimeters. So these are the four constrictions of the esophagus. At the beginning, crossed by the aortic arch, crossed by the left main bronchus, and in the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm. Regarding the arterial supply and venous drainage. Arterial supply. Remember the three parts of the esophagus. In the neck, it is supplied by the inferior thyroid arteries. In the thorax, supplied by branches from the descending thoracic aorta. In the abdomen, branches from the left gastric artery. So arterial supply, in the neck, inferior thyroid arteries, in the thorax, descending thoracic aorta, in the abdomen, left gastric artery. How about the venous drainage? In the neck, inferior thyroid veins, and the inferior thyroid veins will drain into the left brachiocephalic vein. In the thorax, azygous and hemiazygous veins. In the abdomen, left gastric vein, which joins the portal circulation. How about the nerve supply and the lymphatic drainage? Nerve supply of the esophagus. The esophagus is surrounded by the esophageal plexus. This esophageal plexus is formed by sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. parasympathetic to vagus nervous, and the two vagus nervous form the anterior and the posterior gastric nervous. The left vagus forms the anterior gastric nerve, the right vagus forms the posterior gastric nerve. Regarding the sympathetic, from the sympathetic ganglia in the thorax, from the first to the fifth thoracic ganglia, and from the greater splanchnic nerve, which arises from the fifth to the tenth ganglia. So two vagus nerves and the sympathetic ganglia. Thoracic sympathetic ganglia from number 1 to number 9. Regarding the lymph drainage in the neck, the deep cervical lymph nodes, in the thorax, the mediastinal lymph nodes, and in the abdomen, it will drain along the left gastric artery to the celiac lymph nodes. So deep cervical lymph nodes in the neck, mediastinal lymph nodes in the thorax, and the celiac lymph nodes in the abdomen. And thank you very much, best wishes, and good luck, and see you later.